Welcome to this special episode of SAP's Expert Talk. This is the first part of a two-part video series where we showcase a real customer journey and best practices around SAP S/4HANA Cloud 2SL to 3SL conversion. Today, we're spotlighting dsm-firmenich, a global leader in nutrition, health, and beauty, and the iHealth division's transition from a two-system to a three-system landscape. In this video, we'll focus on how SAP, HCLTech, the partner, and dsm-firmenich, as the customer, collaborated closely to prepare, execute, and deliver a very successful three-system landscape conversion. In the second video, and we hope you will watch it too, we will focus more on the business benefits. To bring this story to life, we're joined today by two key people who made this story happen. Samantha Bates from HCLTech, project manager leading the technical team at iHealth.
Hello.
Welcome, Samantha.
Thank you.
And Ancuta, 3SL Conversion Customer Office, SPOC, our single point of contact, who coordinated the SAP side execution and the communication with the customers team. Welcome both. Let's begin.
Hello. Thank you.
I'm Ancuta. Let's begin with the basics and with you, Ancuta. Can you please walk us through the core differences between a two-system and a three-system landscape and how it changes things for the customer?
So in the two-system landscape, customers typically work with the quality and the production system. Testing and development usually happens in the same quality environment, which can sometimes lead to limitations, especially when managing parallel projects and upgrades. The three-system landscape introduces a new, dedicated new test system between the dev and prod systems for dsm-firmenich iHealth division, who was already using the central business configuration. This change meant isolating the testing activities, allowing for more stable project delivery, fewer transport conflicts, and a better change management. The possibility to use the development tenant 080 for the developer extensibility with ABAP Cloud was also a great addition, which I know it was super important for the iHealth division.
That is a great breakdown, Ancuta, and benefit for the project is clear. We'll look at that a bit later. For anyone watching who wants to dig deeper, we've linked to the 3SL community pages in the description, where you can find more technical resources and all the how-to guides that will help you go step by step through the same projects. Now let's shift into the real world execution, Ancuta. How did the collaboration with our customer, dsm-firmenich, iHealth, unfold during that project?
From my perspective, it was an outstanding collaboration between SAP's conversion team and HCLTech iHealth division. I was the single point of contact, but there were a lot of work streams behind me involving the technical delivery of the three-system landscape. Sam and the iHealth team approached this project with a clear focus to match the commitment of the different work streams within SAP's conversion program. From the technical conversion to the go-live, the project wrapped up in just 23 days, which is a really impressive timeline. From day one, I had a good alignment with Sam and the customer's team. We used the SAP Activate roadmap for conversion. We had weekly syncs, a shared group chat, and clearly assigned responsibilities. The plan was to be able to respond to any customer questions or doubts as fast as possible. One standout aspect was how quickly the customer self-enabled and committed to understanding the post-conversion tasks and how to use the three-system landscape. There was also a training provided by SAP to support the customer in the journey of self-enablement necessary before the productive conversion event planned for their system.
Now, from your perspective, Sam, as the partner managing the customer team, how did the process feel in terms of preparation, delivery, and then, of course, the overall collaboration between the two companies?
The relationship I had with Ancuta from the very beginning was very focused and driven. It was an excellent collaboration with SAP, dsm-firmenich and HCLTech. We started a lot earlier with the preparations. We're using SAP Activate as our methodology throughout the entire process. You can't go wrong with that. It's detailed and thorough throughout. It helped us self-enable the team as we went through. So all the way through to being prepared for our critical day one activities, setting up that new test system, performing data loads, configuring the integration rewiring, and setting up the transport management and enabling the ABAP development in the new temp We did that in just 23 days. We also took on some of the pilot schemes from SAP that were offered, so the CIAS to help doing our integration, and also the test data refresh service, which just whacked the data in for us very, very simply.
Did you say 23 days?
23 days.
That is remarkable.
I felt so proud.
Congratulations. I'm proud of you, too. Completing all the post-conversion tasks in such a short time frame is no small feat. Sam, let's now go a bit deeper. What were some of the more challenging moments and how did you address them, you know, the people perspective, project perspective?
So the most challenging part for me was it was a new thing for us to do. So trying to work out the timescales with the team because it was new for them as well. So we spent a lot of time digging deep into the self-enablement, taking advantage of some of the training that was offered by SAP coming up to that conversion to make sure that we were really key on what it was that we were delivering on that critical day one. That was our biggest challenge there.
It's clear that all this upfront investment in planning paid off.
Yes.
Obviously.
Yes.
Let's switch gear a bit, Sam. For others watching who are considering a 3SL conversion and many customers are lining up, what would be your key recommendations after this experience?
Clear project plan. Take the pilot schemes that are offered by SAP, the CIAS, which is all of your integrations, the test data refresh, and the test data conversion itself, which will take a copy of your old quality system and make it into your new test system.
Okay, so CIS is Cloud Integration Automation Services.
Yes.
That's a great tip, Sam, I think, to follow those steps. Ancuta, to you, as we're approaching the end of this this talk, any closing thoughts from your side on what make this project stand out?
Yeah, I just want to say that what really stood out to me was the trust and transparency between everyone involved, whether it was between STEM and me or the technical experts working on the conversion. Each conversion case is what we are calling a unicorn, and the SAP conversion program treats everyone with full focus and care with one clear goal, helping the customer succeed. From the start, we had open communication, very clear expectations, and a dedicated team that really wanted to make it work. That kind of teamwork and trust between SAP, HCLTech as the partner, and the iHealth division of dsm-firmenich is what turns a regular project into a real success story.
Thank you so much, both, for this insightful and very successful discussion. I'm really happy to hear when you put the right people together with the right objective that it really turns out in 23 days to a big success. The dsm-firmenich iHealth division truly exemplify what's possible when customer, partner, and SAP hopefully come together with this shared goal. As next, in part two of this series, we'll explore the long-term business benefits of the 3SL model, including automation for the integration, rewiring, and the impact on daily operations. So if you're planning your 3SL journey, check out the links in the descriptions for helpful resources. Visit our SAP community and contact us with insightsfor@sap.com. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you in the next episode.